Hi everyone, I'm Sonal Sonawani. I'm a psychologist by profession. I'm also a founder of CEDAR, which stands for Center for Depression, Anxiety and Relationships. Being a mental health professional, I was at once in my life in this phase where I did not want to live. I was struggling with my own mental health. 3 years ago, I moved from my hometown to another city, Mumbai. And over there, you know, I faced a lot of issues. My relationship was really, really turning sour and bitter, not only with my boyfriend back then, but also with my family. It was a very lonely journey, a very, very lonely journey back there. But I think there was something genetic about what I experienced as well. Because the reason that I took up psychology was that my uncle, when I was in 10th grade, committed suicide. And he was going through depression for the longest time. And I made it a mission in my life to study the subject and to help as many people as possible. And a lot of people would be surprised that despite being a mental health professional, why did I not deal with my own emotions at that point of time? Why could I not? Why did I not reach out for help? There is no shame in accepting your vulnerabilities. There is no shame in accepting that these were the thoughts or are the thoughts that you are experiencing. Every thought and emotion is valid. May not be rational, but valid. Nobody was there to witness the pain that I was going through and experiencing when I was alone. But that night, it gave me an idea. But why is it so difficult to access quality mental health? Why is it so difficult to just pick up the phone and call someone and talk to someone? And that is when the idea of CEDAR was born. So that is when it became Center for Depression, Anxiety, Relationships, CEDAR, CEDAR. Honestly, it's a self-funded organization. I had no money. I literally had no money. I left my job. I was staying in Mumbai all alone. I had bills to pay. I couldn't go back to my hometown and be with my parents. Because again, for me, it would be start of another journey, and I did not want to look back in my life at that point of time. So yes, I did face a lot of financial struggles because having being self-funded is very, very difficult. Around the same time, two or three NGOs did get in touch with me to help them design training programs. And these organizations, I think, realized that, so they approached me, and so yeah, that's how CEDAR started, honestly. When your intention is pure, everything around you just works out for you. You know, when your own consciousness shifts, when you're more aware about yourself, what you wish to do, when you're very, very certain and genuine about what you wish to do, somehow, you find opportunities, you turn challenges into opportunities. There is no way that a challenge is only perceived as a challenge and then you sit and cry about it. I'm so happy and I'm so glad that I am being a part of this platform where I can talk about my journey. It is about women who are willing to inspire others and who come to be inspired. And inspiration is everything. I hope you have your dreams that you can make come true, and you also turn every challenge that you're facing into an opportunity. Thank you so much for listening to me.